Welcome back to my channel. Today I have another hair experiment for you, which by recent vote was chosen to be the first in line. Over the past few weeks, I've been testing how hydrogen peroxide affects brown hair. If you are curious about the mixtures I used, the level of lightening I achieved, and some interesting effect I observed, make sure to stay until the end of the video. For this experiment, I used natural dark brown hair samples with a warm tone. I decided to use several different hydrogen peroxide mixtures to compare the differences. The first strand, marked with a light pink color, was treated with 3% hydrogen peroxide. The strand, marked with purple, was exposed to 6% hydrogen peroxide. The next strand, marked beige, was treated with a mixture of 6% hydrogen peroxide and a strong chamomile flower infusion in 1-to-1 ratio, ultimately resulting in a 3% concentration. Two additional strands were treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide with the addition of essential oils. The orange marked strand had citrus essential oil added, while the yellow marked strand contained chamomile essential oil. The final strand, marked blue, is our control sample. I prepared 5 bowls, each marked with a different color to avoid confusing when mixing the solutions. In the first bowl, I combined 6% hydrogen peroxide with an equal amount of distilled water, creating a 3% solution. The second bowl contained pure 6% hydrogen peroxide. In the next one, I mixed 6% hydrogen peroxide with an equal amount of strong chamomile infusion, again resulting in a final concentration of 3%. The last two bowls contain 6% hydrogen peroxide, with one having 4 drops of lemon essential oil and the other the same amount of chamomile essential oil. One by one, I dipped the hair samples in their solutions and then left them for about an hour before washing them with a gentle shampoo. Here you can see the results after first use of hydrogen peroxide and a comparison of all the strands against the control sample. The first strand treated with 3% hydrogen peroxide showed a slightly lightening effect compared to the control. The strand treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide appeared noticeably lighter with more intense reddish undertones, which become even more noticeable when compared to the 3% strand. The sample treated with the hydrogen peroxide and chamomile infusion mixture also showed subtle lightening similar to the first strand. Additionally, the color appeared cooler compared to the strand treated with pure hydrogen peroxide. The strands treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide combined with either citrus or chamomile essential oils all seemed to lighten in a similar way at this stage. Here you can see the comparison of the hair strands after the third application. The hair was also washed and dried. The lightening effect became more pronounced compared to the first application, as you can see in the video clips. The strand treated with 3% hydrogen peroxide and the chamomile mixture seems to be the darkest of all, with a cooler tone. Among the strands treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide, I didn't notice any significant differences in the degree of lightening. They all seemed quite similar, but let me know in the comments if you see any differences. I continued the experiment, and here you can see the results after 15 applications. The lightening effect became much more noticeable even on the strands treated with 3% hydrogen peroxide. There was also a clear difference in lightening between the 3 and 6% hydrogen peroxide treated strands. Interestingly, the strands treated with pure hydrogen peroxide had more intense reddish hue, while the strand treated with the hydrogen peroxide and chamomile mixture had a more neutral, ashy tone. The effect was also slightly visible in the strand treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide and chamomile essential oil compared to the other samples treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide. Now you can see the comparison of the strands after 20 applications. The results are similar to the previous one, but the lightening effect has become even more pronounced. The difference between the strands treated with the chamomile mixture and the one treated with pure hydrogen peroxide is now very noticeable. The hair treated with the chamomile mixture appears closer to a dark or even medium blonde, while the strand treated with pure 3% hydrogen peroxide goes more towards a warm reddish hue. The difference is also clear in the strand treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide and chamomile essential oil. Based on my previous experiment with chamomile on blonde hair, I would assume that chamomile infusion can add a warm tone to the hair color. However, in this case, it seems that the chamomile mixture could be used for those who want to lighten brown hair while maintaining cooler blonde shades rather than warm reddish tones. The discovery led me to another question. What happens when you mix hydrogen peroxide with a blue dye? I decided to use a plant you might remember from my previous experiments, butterfly pea flowers. I brewed a strong infusion from the flowers and combined equal parts of the infusion with 6% hydrogen peroxide. Since the strand treated with 6% hydrogen peroxide and those with the citrus essential oil looked the same, I decided to use them for the part of the test. I dipped one of the strands in the prepared mixture and left it for about an hour. First, I wanted to see if there was a visible difference before washing, and then check whether the effect would remain after shampooing. As you can see, the hair took on a slightly cooler tone, meaning that adding butterfly pea flower infusion could help neutralize unwanted warm shade when lightening hair with hydrogen peroxide. After shampooing, the color washed away. However, this was just one-time application. In the case of hydrogen peroxide and chamomile infusion, the cool blonde effect became noticeable over time with repeated applications of the mixture. Therefore, when it comes to the hydrogen peroxide and butterfly pea flower infusion blend, I believe that regular use of this combination could result in more lasting effects. I also tried rinsing a strand that had been previously lightened with 6% hydrogen peroxide and chamomile essential oil in pure butterfly pea flower infusion to see if it would neutralize warm shade. The answer is yes, but the effect wasn't as strong as when I tested the method on blonde hair in a mentioned video. Lastly, I want to show you a comparison of all the lightened strands with a strand of my blonde hair that I saved from my last haircut. This allows you to see how some of the strands got quite close to blonde shade. Reddish tones can easily be toned down using the right hair rinses, while butterfly pea flower rinses might not be strong enough to achieve a cool blonde tone in this case, there are many more powerful and longer lasting toning products available. I also want to mention that this experiment was done on hair samples, so I didn't have to worry about the effects of frequent hydrogen peroxide use on overall hair condition. While the strands still look shiny and healthy, be careful if you want to try on your own hair. Our hair is exposed to many factors like sun, wind, humidity, dry air, washing or styling. Every hair type reacts differently, so I recommend using hydrogen peroxide in small amounts, no more than once a week. Before applying it to your whole hair, always test it on a small hidden strand to make sure you are happy with the result. To prevent dryness, use conditioners, masks, and oils between lightening sessions and avoid heat styling. If you would like to see how I personally use hydrogen peroxide on my hair, check out the video on my channel. I will leave all the useful links in the description. Let me know if this video was useful and share your thoughts in the comments. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. See you in the next video. Bye bye!